We just had our Snakehead tournament pretty much start today. And just wanted to go over some questions we had this past week and today about pretty much locations, and especially Blackwater. As you can see here in the map, we got the whole Blackwater area. We did have some actual comments for you guys and tips on where to go fishing there. And the reason why we're doing this is because you guys might have heard there's certain areas that have been posted now for no parking or just not fishing in general, but most of them are just no parking. So you can still fish in that area. Just remember, you just got to find some other way to park. So let's start off with some of the general areas where we had these comments, and pretty much we know that no parking signs have been placed. And the first one is one of the most common ones where everybody was going. And as you can see, this is Key Wallace Road, right at Key Wallace Bridge. In the past, you were able to pretty much park all along the side of the road here, which became a safety issue more than anything. It just became a thing for, you know, just traffic. So you're still able to fish all this area here, except now you have to park all the way in this parking area. So right where I dropped that pin, that's pretty much the parking. As you can see, it's not that big of a parking area, but now you have to park there and walk yourself all the way down to the, you know, whatever your spot is in that, you know, side of the road there or the bridge. So besides that, there is an entrance here for a I guess like a little entrance to the actual refuge where you can drive all throughout this section here, and you have to check that out because you can probably fish all of that too if you're willing to do a little bit of hike or just drive around and mess around and fish here and there throughout that. You might want to stop at the visitor center there and talk to them and see what the actual, you know, rules are about that. But I've seen people fish here before. Now this is your most general area here, and this is specifically for you guys shore fishing or kayak fishing. This is a Blackwater soft launch. You can see not a huge area to park there, so limited space, but you can definitely park there and walk on the rocks here and fish. If you have a kayak, then you can go all throughout this whole general area here. Now, other than that, we have Maple Dam Road, which is on the Little Blackwater here. Little Blackwater, I believe most of it has been posted to for no parking. There might be some exceptions in certain areas, but before where you were able to park right on those two little coves, I believe you cannot longer do that. So that takes that away, but you still have limited access right up here. And as you can see, Google doesn't mark it, so you might have to do a little research. But right on there, it's what it's called Egypt Road soft launch there. So once again, you drive through this little driveway here, get yourself down there. I've personally fished a lot, and it's a limited area for, you know, just parking, even in that soft launch. So got to get there early, get some spots. And of course, as most people know, we have your most popular sections of the, I guess, general Blackwater area, Cambridge area. And this is a Transquaking. Now, guys, on these boat launches or boat ramps, they're starting to post signs. If not, they already have done them most. I know I've been to Newbridge and they already done that there, where they've posted boat trailer parking only. So a lot of those spots have been pretty much wiped out for, you know, anybody just park there. Transquaking, I've seen a couple pictures from a week ago or two where you were able to still park all the way back here. Just remember, leave some space for the guys on the boats, that way there's no issues. But you can shore fish on the actual bridge there, if there's any parking. And then of course, once you get down to Newbridge, that's the one I was just speaking of here, that's the one that has been posted for trailers only. I know a couple of areas on the road that people used to be able to park on the side of the road have been actually posted to with no parking signs. So a lot of those areas has been a little difficult for that, and, you know, loosen, you know, access to some of those areas. If you go down below here, you have what we call, you know, the pretty much drawbridge second general area, and this is in the Chimacamaco, and you can park here, and on the side, as you can see, and fish a little pier there. So Blackwater, once again, a little more limited now. Still plenty of areas to pretty much fish in there. If you have a kayak or a boat, seems that that's going to be the general area where you want to take your kayak and your boat and cover some water. As you can see, it's a massive area and lots of general places to go there and access points if you're on watercraft or whatnot. Plenty of other areas throughout the eastern shore, guys, so don't worry about, you know, not being able to catch snakeheads. As we all been hearing for the past year or two, up in Federalsburg, especially fishing that general area there, you can catch a lot of snakeheads. And other than that, you got some more areas pretty much in the Nanticoke. So that's going to be some good areas to kind of, you know, expand your horizons out there, guys, because they're all around the state, especially nowadays. And of course, we have a couple videos about Western Shore fishing and whatnot, so stay tuned for those. But remember, just keep this in mind for next time you go down to Blackwater. And if you have any more questions or anything, make sure you can call, you know, Talbot County down there and see what the whole deal is with that. This is just what I've noticed in the past few trips I've been down there, and just kind of letting you all of you know about that. So, all right, thank you guys, and hopefully this helps you out on your next trip out.